Hey folks, it's Lindsey Hulse with SPS back in the building over at University of Trey Mercy for the second day of the Horatio Williams Foundation basketball team camp. And it's been a great day for Michigan Collegiate. I have head coach Jenorris, JT Jackson, if you know, representing. I had a back-to-back wins, doing good. I just sat with Caleb Moore, one of your star players, also a star quarterback. Man, he was banged up. He had, you know, the fighter's little stitches, the butterfly over his eye, and he was worried about his brother. But talk about the success you guys been having and what's important about Summer League ball right now.
So for us this year coming in, you know, we lost three guys last year, and we returned nine off of the varsity. So we'll have about six guys, seniors this year. Everybody else will be 11th graders, 10th grade.
Uh-huh.
And we're looking for our senior class to do some big things for us this year when it comes in terms to basketball. Like he told you when you talked to Caleb, he's our starting quarterback, and we got about four other, you know, main key players from our football team that's actually on the basketball roster, which gives us that athletic ability, that edge, you know, mm-hmm. that toughness.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if we defend well, some people are going to be in trouble.
Yeah. You mentioned the characteristics and the benefits of having football guys. What does it say about your program, your character? And I will say, you'll see the interview with Caleb. He was surprised at how well things are going with you, him being up under your leadership. But let's talk about what it means to have the football culture as part of your culture for your basketball team right now.
So the biggest thing is when I got to Michigan Collegiate, you know, the program, they bleed three sport athletes.
Wow.
So all of our student athletes play basketball, run track, play football. And if you don't play basketball in the winter, we even have wrestling. That's how deep it is over there in Michigan.
But let's talk about the age-old conflict with coaches worried about players playing another sport and needing to show up. Because you hear it on both sides. And you saying you got to split up through two other sports?
Man, I mean, it's not easy, but we make it work. You know, we understand what the goals are, you know, for the program. You know, we can't be selfish with these kids because you never know. You know, Caleb Moore is our starting quarterback. He's a phenomenal football player. But he just sat here at Detroit Mercy today and put on a clinic in front of some Division I, Division II schools. So you just never know.
Yeah. When I mentioned to him, to your point, I said, between me and you, I was joking when I said that, I said, if you had to choose. And he said, football, because he's getting offered. So talk about the importance of when a kid sees success in something that's tangible. I mean, you get an offer, that's a scholarship, to where you got to be like, well, they showing me love. So how do you kind of justify that when that's right in front of them, as opposed to saying, no, I'm not going to focus on that. I'm going to focus on basketball, because who knows what may happen.
The biggest thing is being honest.
Who being honest?
The coaches.
Okay, thank you.
You know, and then having players being honest with themselves. You know what the world and how basketball and sports are going. If that phone ring for the right cause, you might flip. You might switch what you want to do.
Yeah.
Know? And granted, he's getting some football scholarships, but like I told him, don't put all your eggs in one basket.
Yeah.
You know, because you might be a quarterback in high school, and I'm pretty sure you can be a quarterback in college, but it just depends on where you go.
Where you go, you know? In the situation, because they talk about, what's the term, stacking, where they'll put you somewhere and they want to switch you somewhere else. One other thing you said, you've always been a humble guy, and I appreciate that. He talked about the surprise and what he expected from you and how it is, and he talked about the bond and the connection. Talk about that, man, connecting with these young people, you know, in a genuine way where he can publicly state, man, me and Coach JT, man, we tight, you know.
So the biggest thing is I work in the building. So I see these kids every day. You know, that's the biggest thing.
Oh, you ain't, it's not 4 o'clock. I'm going to call your coach. You right there on the air.
every interaction, you know, every problem, every situation, you know, I'm standing in the lunchroom. We kicking it.
Uh-huh.
You know, we talking about grades. We talking about sports, you know, and I keep it real with them. You know?
I know you do.
Because outside of this, the real world exists. So my thing is all my guys know, for whatever, don't hesitate. You know, conversation, you need a ride.
Yeah.
And I don't even got to go into detail because you know. But my thing is with these guys, they know I got their back regardless if you're on my team or not.
That's great. Was that 7 years at, you know, public safety to help you, you know, develop that kind of characteristic? You know, talk about being that kind of coach. How did you get to this point?
So being at public safety for so long under the tutelage of my uncle, Ron Booth, who's still over at public safety now, you know, he's had me since 5th grade. So being around a great guy, a humble guy, I picked up some, you know, characteristics from him, and I just molded it with what I already had, and it showed me how to, you know, navigate through this game. You know, I left public safety. I coached in the PSL over at King for a season with Coach Ward.
Uh-huh.
Being around him, you know, got to give credit to him.
Shout out to G Ward.
Shout out to G Ward. He's a great teacher. He's a great mentor. But most importantly, he's a real black man. Being around things like that, as a young guy, it helped me,
sure,
you know, with my grind.
Sure.
And I appreciate everybody that's gave me the opportunity, sure, so far.
Last thing, when you talk about opportunities, talk about the patience that's involved with, quote-unquote, waiting your turn, waiting for opportunities, taking advantage of opportunities, what's a good opportunity, what's not. I mean, talk about that whole process.
Every spot is not the spot for everybody.
But I'm so excited. I'm getting a call. They're showing me love. They're reaching out. Man, this will be, we can make this work, man. I've been waiting for this opportunity. Everything ain't perfect. I'm trying to work out. You feel what I'm saying? I'm just trying to challenge that.
More so on my end, you know, I have to be in a spot where they let me grind. You know, I'm passionate about what I do.
Yep.
I'm loud.
Yep.
You know, I don't hold back. And if they're going to let me work how I work, that's the spot for me.
Damn, that's a G-Ward tree. Shout out to G-Ward again. No, I get that, and I appreciate you being able to say that. And the proof is in the pudding when you have these young men who have opportunity, and they can say how much they appreciate you. You're doing a great job representing well. Can't believe it's been all this time we haven't sat down in front of the camera. Anything else you want to share? Any shout-outs you want to give before we let you go?
Shout out to, you know, you.
I appreciate it.
You know, you're my guy, and I appreciate what you're doing for the game.
Yes,
not only the game, but the whole student athlete.
Thank you.
But also, shout out to Horatio.
Yeah.
You know, for putting this on. You know, yes, this needs to be here.
Let's talk about it. Why was that important, man? You know, you got the history of the city. Why was it important being able to come here for a event like this?
This is important for city, not only our city kids, but the Metro Detroit area, because if Detroit Mercy doesn't have a few kids from around here on this roster, it's not Detroit brand basketball.
Detroit brand basketball. I love that. I love that. I love that. You know, the athletic director, Mr. Viles, made a good point. He said there's two things that's necessary. You know, one, you want to be engaged with the community, and two, you want to win. And if you ain't winning and you're not engaged in the community, there's nothing you can do. At least if you lose and then you engage, you know, you can have the barbershop talk that'll give you a little bit of pass, people to, you know, buy in. But to have both that engagement as well as this winning culture that Coach Montgomery's bringing, I think it'll be good for the city.
I'm excited to see what they do to turn this thing around.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah,
the expectation is high, but I think they can win more than one game.
I think they can win more than one game, no doubt. And they got great prospects like the young man you working with. That, hey, we got some great things to talk about. Are you done for the day? You got any more today?
Done for the day. It's time for those boys to go throw the ball out of Troy tonight at 7:07. So I'm about to go watch them do that.
That's awesome. They see you on the sideline with,
yes,
that, sir, too.
I
love it.
I actually coach football, too.
Hey, he's doing it all. Hey, he's staying at Michigan Collegiate. Don't be blowing him up. Talking about we got an opportunity somewhere. He's working on something right here, man.
Yes,
you don't like that. Great job. Hey, sitting here at the Horatio Williams Foundation, day two of the basketball team camp. It's a great thing. And Lindsey Nelson with SPS. We'll see you next time. Peace. I'm